hills here in Bohol. They seem to be a different flavor right now, Ronnie.
Right, right. A little bit of green.
Yes, indeed. And, well, the height of summer will change that. This is Pinoy Pride 12. And we are looking at Michael Domingo, a veteran, very deeply experienced, against Marvin Tampus. And, of course, everybody's familiar with Michael Domingo, one of our discoveries back in 1998 in our TV program Knockout.
Sobrang galing ito si Michael Domingo, pero he's been unlucky.
Yes.
He's been unlucky because just when he was on the fringes of a world title fight, he was discovered to have hepatitis B.
Yes.
So he couldn't fight in the States, came back home, he was cured, and now he's back on the trail. But this, sinabi nila sa akin, this is the last fight of Michael Domingo.
Wow.
If he does not win handsomely.
Yes. And, you know, a lot of talented fighters internationally are afraid to fight Michael Domingo because they have everything to lose. And he's very dangerous, especially tough on defense. And at the tail of the tape, you can see the slight height advantage of Domingo. And we turn you over now to our ring announcer to make the official introduction.
Maayong gabi, Tagbilaran! Our next bout of the evening is 8 rounds of boxing in the super bantamweight division. Introducing first, in the blue corner, wearing red trunks and white trims, his weight 122.5 pounds. His record 27 wins 18 by way of knockouts, 14 defeats and 2 draws. Ladies and gentlemen, from Bohol, Leyte, please welcome Marvin Tampus. His opponent in the red corner, wearing black trunks with white trims. His weight, 123 pounds. His record, 43 wins, 22 by way of knockouts, 16 defeats and 2 draws. Ladies and gentlemen, from Sultan Kudarat, this is Michael Bruce Lee Domingo! Our judges for the bout, international judge Salvin Lagumbay, Noel Flores, and Edwin Barrientos. Your referee, Ben Necesario. 8 rounds of boxing.
All right, this is going to be a very interesting matchup. And of course, Michael Domingo, everybody knows, rock solid clamshell defense, hard to get to, hard to hit. He has a very good work rate also. And Marvin Tampus looks a little worried going into this
fight. See Marvin Tampus fighting in Lilo on Cebu in the Stonewall stable of Terry Carter.
Yes.
He's a very promising young man then. But he had a couple of setbacks in his last 2 fights. But he's a solid, solid fighter, and he's fighting the red trunk with the white trim down the side. See, Michael Domingo naman, Bill, parang decent engine, it's a slow start.
Very good.
Very
yes.
Slow start. But he knows now he has to prove himself in this fight. Mm-hmm. If he's to continue fighting, otherwise, Palagayko, he'll become a good trainer in the allergy.
That is true, that is true. And, you know, somebody who can mold future champions as well, because he's very, very disciplined. Just as you mentioned, had a couple of, you know, turning points in his career where he could have become a world champion. But make no doubt about it, he's a very solid fighter.
Very solid fighter. I remember when he fought one of Oscar De La Hoya's big name undefeated fighters and beat him, and Oscar De La Hoya couldn't believe it.
Yes.
That was in your coverage of the Philippines versus Mexico in the World Cup of Boxing.
True.
In the Arco Arena in Sacramento. Alam mo na si Michael Domingo is a leader doon sa Ala Gym.
Mm-hmm.
He is an example for all the other young guys to follow.
Walang bisyo,
mabait.
Shows leadership by example as well. And you know, in, if you're...
He's down. Body shot. That was a left to the body. That was
he's pounding the canvas in pain. And,
yeah, that's gone.
And that is very hard to do.
This is over. This is over.
He can't shake it off, and it is over.
He's doing what Oscar De La Hoya did when Bernard Hopkins caught him with a body shot.
And you were saying about winning handsomely, Ronnie?
Yes.
I was just going to explain the Tampus family name.
He's angry. He's upset with himself.
And he's in pain.
He's in pain. He's rolling in pain. That was a real shot to the liver. Dr. René Bonsoubre is there attending to him. He's a writer as well as a gap doctor.
And all that training, all that
I think you want partner. Yun gusto ko si ala. Saka ABS-CBN. Everything is there.
Yes.
All the equipment is there. The oxygen
all the precautions.
Tank, all the doctors are there. The stretchers are there. Everything is there.
All right. Let's check out our Cobra Punch.
Time now for the Cobra Tunay na Lakas Punch of the Round.
Here it is. Oh. Left uppercut. You know, midsection.
To the midsection. He put the full weight of his shoulder behind the punch. Watch it again.
Yes.
Oh.
And you see the hip rotation there. That generates the centrifugal force that really buries that punch.
And look at him. Bang the canvas with his fist.
He can't shake off the pain. And it sends shockwaves throughout your body and you really can't even get up.
Why did I do that? So, very, very impressive first round KO victory by Michael Domingo.
It's about time.
And he's going to keep fighting, for sure.
That's for sure. Let's go up to the ring and get the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 1:28, and the first round, your winner by way of knockout, Michael Bruce Lee Domingo!
Spectacular win, and you know, speak softly and carry a big stick. That's Mike Domingo tonight.
I'm happy for him, Bill, kasi mabait nitong bata nito.
Mm-hmm.